talking, breaking the wrist late, forearms, all that stuff. How does that actually happen? You need to lock a wrist to unlock it to generate power. Now what happens is, if you look at it, it said, the book said that you need to cock wrist to pick up a bat. Cock wrist is nothing but I'm breaking the wrist when I pick up the bat. Now that gives complete control to my top hand. What also it ensures is when I'm playing the ball and my hand extends, the wrist is still locked. At the last minute, the wrist gives me that extra power because it's the fastest moving muscle. At the same time, I can open it wherever I want, so I get power and placement. In terms of an uncocked wrist, if I play the same shot and extend, my wrist is already given. So the last part of bat speed which I'm trying, I do not get it. At the same time, it's very difficult for me to place the ball. So everything comes down to a cocked wrist, and you uncock it at the last minute, and that's what you hear on TV saying breaking the wrist late. So breaking the wrist is nothing but uncocking the wrist, which gives you power and placement as you wanted, and that increases the bat speed tremendously when you meet the ball.